Part 16, let's continue this shower thing. So you can actually reduce the segments on this one a bit. About 20. Just make sure you have smooth turned on. We have quite a nice looking shower thing, although I'm going to reduce the radius on that a bit. Just because it doesn't look quite right. Alright, and let me get dimensions for how far up this is. So this thing is an inch down and an inch away from the light fixture, or the switch. Select a box. Width 1. I'm just zooming in the box here. W. And just position it. Rotate it 90 degrees. And position this one. Scaling down a bit. Oh yes, that is it. this stays. Right, this is what it looks like, which is more or less exactly what the real one looks like. So, that is all good. Next, what we want to do is make a cap for this, if you will. So, just make a small cylinder up here, and actually select these two things here, and isolate selection. Slide this over here. And if I can find my other selection. There we go. And let's go to the 4D mode. Just press Z. Center here, just eyeball it. Alright, blow up the perspective, convert this to an editable poly. You can turn the side down on this. Set this a bit. Okay, then grow, deselect that, then extrude, and just extrude that way a bit. Select the entire thing, and looks like we're going to need to scale it up a bit. What we're going for is just a cap loop. Okay, control click, chamfer. Alright, 0.01 is pretty good. And just to make things nice, give it a auto smooth. I want to render this out once just to be sure. And just so you know, this means I have global illumination on. And it needs photon emitters for that to actually work properly. So that's why I'm getting that error. Alright, so we can see that we need to scale this up and bring it back a bit. So select it. Scale it up a bit. And these verts here, and just scoot them back a bit. Alright, but now we should be pretty good. So exit isolation mode. Select that group, and let's call this door stop. And this is supposed to go down, so bring it to about this level. And let's just bring it out a bit. Let me go check the exact dimensions of these. And these are both 23.5 inches from their respective doors, so create a box. Width is going to be 23.5, go to the top view, and just slide it up against the edge of the wall. Perspective, we can bring it down to, I guess, and then out. Select our group here. Let's just bring it closer to the top. It's right around here. Slide it in. And slide it over. Next, you're just going to want to make a copy of that, or instance, either way. And that'll have to be it for this part. I'll see you. Actually, no, let me finish. No. Alright, I'll see you in the next part.